St. Louis, it is Fashion Revolution Day today. And this day, people join forces to really help the future of the fashion industry. I mean, to think, we all used to wear clothes like that. Who knew? Joining us now is celebrity historian Raffi Andonian. Raffi, thanks for being here with us today.
Thank you for having me.
Of course.
As you point out, how you choose to wrap yourself says something about your personality.
It does. What does this say about my personality?
I would say colorful, yes. Flamboyant, and strong personality.
Yes, very dramatic. I mean, you hit the nail right on the head. And then I like these aviators that you brought in.
That's right.
I mean, if people aren't familiar with you, tell us a little bit about what you do and how you became this history buff.
I became a history buff by visiting historic sites and being fascinated by the power of beautiful buildings, beautiful outfits, the stuff that you see brings it alive. And then over time, what happened is eventually I put out some books on history. I worked at different historic sites, and I started doing appearances on TV, doing fun TV segments and about history. So that's how, you know, became
a celebrity historian. Oh, my gosh. I love it. Well, we are breaking down fashion today. Let's start with these aviators here. You can't go wrong with a pair of aviators.
You can't. And it speaks to the power of accessories in fashion, which has been around for thousands of years in some fashion. For example, 100,000 years ago, you can find evidence of seashells being used not only in outfits, but to accessorize. Yes, that's right. Even 30,000 plus years ago, you find evidence of beads starting to come out in Russia, for example. Of course, it's not Russian nation at the time, but in that region. So the power of using accessories, the glasses, in my case, the bow tie.
Yeah, the bow tie.
Especially the pink one, colorful and flamboyant like you.
I am here for all of this,
Robbie. It's going to speak to that, right? So the accessories are really valuable for a long period of time across centuries.
Nice. What else have you brought in for us today?
Well, one of the things that you see hundreds of thousands of years ago, almost a million years ago, in archaeology is the use of scrapers to get animal hides and turn them into fashion pieces. So I brought together to me today a wallet. The wallet is made out of goat hide. That's what that's made out of. It comes from Uganda. That's my wallet.
Wowza.
That's right.
Oh my gosh.
Now, you may not have a wallet being made 800,000 years ago, but the concept of using an animal hide for fashion begins nearly a million years ago. You find that in northern China, and half a million years ago, you find it in what is today England. So it's been around for a long time.
That is amazing. I mean, just to think that fashion goes back all of those years, 10, 20, 30, 40,000 years ago. I mean, people were styling and profiling, right?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
I mean, let's talk about the industry here in St. Louis. How did St. Louis come to be such a hub for fashion?
A few different reasons. One of them is that it is at the center of the railroads and the center of industry in the late 19th and early 20th century. Now, what happens is, compared to earlier, by the time you reach the era of the 20th century, there is this thing known as ready-to-wear, which is not necessarily custom tailoring. And so when you do ready-to-wear, these department stores have these kind of standardized styles, if you will. What happens is younger women in 1920s and 30s say, we don't want to look like our mothers and grandmothers.
Forget that.
They wanted different kinds of styles on them, ruffles on the wrist, the collars, shorter skirts, different things. So St. Louis has a department store that's one of the first, perhaps the first, that takes young women's styles seriously. And in the process, they collaborate with students at Washington University here, Washington, St. Louis, and create this line known as the junior line. It's really for young women that's more stylish.
That's where juniors came from?
That's right.
Oh, my gosh.
And that's what makes St. Louis really blow up. At one point, 20,000 people in St. Louis are working for the fashion industry, second only to New York City.
And that's your history lesson for today. Raffi, thank you so much for being here with us today. I'm all about fashion, so doing this, having you on to introduce us to all of our audiences about the fashion world and history truly was a treat, so thank you.
Thank you.
Of course, St. Louis. If you want to show Raffi some love, he is the celebrity historian. You can visit him online at celebrityhistorian.com. You can also show him some love on Facebook, on Instagram, and on YouTube. And I think it's time for me to fly high with my aviators. Raffi says they're in style, so I'll take it. Don't go anywhere, St. Louis. We'll be right back after this quick break.